But when you talk about destruction,
don't you know that you can count
it's time.
Oh no.
Got a real solution. Well, you know.
The CS theme, rapid industrialization is changing the face of economy in Russia.
The number of factories has doubled so far, and we are expecting even more growth in the near future.
We are also working on the world's largest railroad track with British and French inventors.
Communism by Older Spice. The one deodorant that can make every man smell the same.
Alright, now time for the taste.
Smells the same!
Russian workers do not like their working conditions and also the payment they are receiving. So they are striking in order to try to get better working conditions and more pay. I'm going to interview one of them to see what is happening at their jobs.
You in the blue shirt, come.
Yes.
Sir, why are you striking?
See, what? The bosses. They treat us not very well, and we do not get that good of pay. But we want more money and better conditions.
As a result to poor working conditions, multiple different revolutionary groups have sprung out from the workers. One of the first groups is the Marxist. A second group that branched off from them is the Bolsheviks, which is led by Lenin. As you can see here, workers are still uncomfortable with the conditions that they have at their jobs and the pay that they are receiving. And this, I feel, will soon lead to a revolution. I am solo back at the scene to check if there are any more strikes happening at the moment. But it seems that there is nobody there, except I just noticed one of the workers we saw previously at the original strike is still here. And he doesn't look like he's in too good of a shape. So I'm going to go over and do another interview on him. Sir, why are you still out here after the strikes have ended?
Because I do not have a home, I do not have a family, I do not have a job. I lost my daughter after I got injured. Hello, my name is Oswald. I used to be like you guys. I had a job, a nice family. Until one day I lost it all. I wasn't paying attention one day because I was so tired because all the bad working conditions. I sawed my arm right off. I was so in shock, I fell down. Next thing you know, my eye came out. I hit it too hard. Very sad day. I woke up, no one was with me in the hospital. I found out my family had left me. They didn't want to cripple. My work wasn't gonna pay any insurance or none of that. It's hard to talk about, man. It's been a really hard year. You know, I even had two kids. I haven't talked to them in forever. I just really hope that the working conditions are getting better. No one has to deserve what I go through. I do what I go through. It's very bad, very bad. Just please, people, start the revolution. Make it happen.
Are workers talking about a revolution?
Yes, I hear him. Sorry. But I didn't have enough money to remove it, so it's just very infected. Yes, they are talking about it. I hear them all the time. Even the voices in my head talk to me about them, man. It'll happen. It'll happen. Everything will get better.
Is it happening soon?
I hope so. I think so. It's going to work out for the better.
Mm. Thank you so much for your input, sir. It means a lot to me.
Just help make it happen, man. Just help make it happen.
Spend all your time waiting for that second chance, for a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction.
For just 10 cents a day, you can help these workers that have lost their jobs and gotten injured from working conditions. Just 10 cents a day, you can help save their lives.
A few days after the revolution has occurred, what Russian workers that were part of the Bolshevik revolutionist group called themselves the Red Guards and took over the Russian government. Now Russia is controlled by Lenin and his fellow Bolsheviks, and I am lucky enough to have found one of the Red Guard revolutionists, and I'm going to ask him today about how the event has changed his life. All right, let's get into it. Hello, sir.
Yes?
How has the Russian Revolution affected your life today?
Well, let's put it this way. Before the revolution, I used to only get one onion a day. And now, after the revolution and all the land I've been given, now I can get comfortably 5 onions to share with my poor dog.
Oh, it is such a heartwarming story. Thank you for sharing, sir, and have a good day.
The Bolsheviks are going head to head with the White Army, and I have captured in the next scene one of the combat battles. In the next scene, you will also see how easily the Bolsheviks wipe out the White Army.
We want the Tsar's wrath.
We need a democratic government. We don't like Lenin socialism. Down with the Bolsheviks!
But if you go carrying pictures of Chairman Mao, you ain't gonna make it. Then the civil war is finally over between the White Army and the Bolsheviks, but the economy has crashed and we have 14 million Russian deaths on our hands. I'm going to go to the Bolshevik as well as Red Guard that I've previously interviewed and see what he has to say about this event and how he feels about the civil war ending.
Since the civil war, the economy has been at rock bottom, and I've had to give my onions away to the government without nothing in return.
These onions in you, and I'll trade this one with you. These just in, Lenin and the Bolsheviks have made amazing progress in re-growing Russian economy. It is almost back up to where it was before World War I, and also, in an effort to avoid nationalism becoming a threat to Russia, Lenin has established 3 governing states under the rule of one central government in order to control Russia. Now the Communist Party officially and legally holds all power over Russia. Thank you for listening, and this is Newscast Russia out.
together.